Hello and welcome to the Jacaranda part 5, and we're going to start to make round 48. I'll show you how to do that. We're going to start in the first of these 5 front post double crochets that's made around the first around the front post double crochet 5 togethers. So this is These are those. We're going to start here and start in that front post double crochet that's made around it. So we're going to yarn over, go from the back to the front and make a half double crochet, a back post half double crochet. We're going to do this in the next 16 stitches as well. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Let me just count real quick. Should be 17 in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So that's, and 17, that's right. That's exactly the count we need. After that, we're going to make a double treble in round 45 in the chain 5 space that's before this corner shell, or that the corner shell was made into. It's this space. So you can see we made a shell in there. Now we're talking about this space. I'm going to make a double treble in there and we're going to work in front of our work. Double treble is yarn 3 times over. Get into that chain space and just work in front of your corner. Make, just keep taking off all the loops until you're finished your stitch, like this. Chain 2. We're going to make a back post single crochet around the next double crochet. That's this one. Make a back post single crochet, like this. Chain 2. Skipping this picot, working around the next double crochet, make a single back post single crochet. Chain 2, so we're going to do this for all of the double crochets, like this. Lots of back post stitches this round. Some people hate doing them. I find them really relaxing. You can see it makes a very pretty loop at the front. That's how you know it's a back post stitch. I really love back post stitches. I think they're very nice to look at and they make very nice sort of definition to work. After all these back post single crochets and chain twos, last chain two, I'm going to make a double treble, so three times over in the same chain five space that we made already this one in. On the other side, so exactly the same, just keep taking off your loops until you're completing the stitch, like this, like this. After this double treble that we just did, we're going to do the same that we did here and make a back post half double around the next 17 stitches. Just quickly do those. I'll show you. One second. Like this. Just get your 17 half double crochets done. 2, 3. Sorry about that. So we did 3, 4. Five, six, seven, eight, get some more yarn, just did 8, so we're doing 9. 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. You don't really need to count as long as you end up in this, don't really need to count as long as you're doing these stitches and ending up in this half double crochet, then you're fine. But I really do like to count just to make sure. So I just really want to prevent having to take out my work later or having to smuggle later. I just want to do it right the first time. After all those back post half double crochets, we're going to chain two. We're going to skip 2 stitches and we're going to make a single crochet into the next stitch, and that's the second half double crochet of the round before this one. So we're going to skip this one, this stitch, which is a double crochet. This is a half double crochet, the first half double crochet, and in this one, the second half double crochet, we're making a single crochet. That's also a nice marker for you to make sure that you're still your count is still correct. Chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, skip 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, working into the 5th, and making a double crochet in there, like this. Sorry, we're making a double crochet into the next 2 stitches. So we just skipped 4 stitches, made a double crochet, and we're going to make another double crochet. Chain 4, 4, skip 4 stitches again, 1, 2, 3, 4, make a single crochet into the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2. This sequence, chain 4, sequence of chain 4, skipping 4 stitches, double crochet in the next 2 stitches, and chain 4, skipping 4 stitches and doing a single crochet in the next 2 stitches. We're going to repeat that until we're at the end. With the end, I mean end of your long side, or whatever it's called, or the straight side. And after you're done, you're going to do exactly what you did here. So you're going to make all your back post half double crochets around the back post back post double crochet 5 together, etc. So you're just going to mirror everything, get the pattern again to see what your next step is, or get back at the video and do it the other way around. I think you know enough by now. You can do this on your own. When you're done, close with a slip stitch on your first stitch, on your first back post half double crochet, and I'll see you for round 49. Round 49, we're going to continue in the same back post half double crochet that we ended in. So our first back post half double crochet of the previous round. As you can see, I just made a slip stitch. I'm going to continue in there. We're going to chain 3 or chain 2. We're going to make a double crochet or the chain of a first double crochet. I prefer to make a chain 2. The pattern calls for a chain 3, whatever you feel looks nicer in your work. For me, it's a chain 2, that's why I always make a chain 2 when I start instead of a double crochet. And we're going to make a double crochet into the next 16 stitches. So, this is the first stitch that we worked in. That's the half double crochet made into the or the back post half double crochet made into the front post half double crochet of the previous round. Make a double crochet into the next 16 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. That's 16 double crochets made up until the corner, and if your stitch count is correct, you should be at the double treble of a previous round. We're going to make, oh sorry, I didn't finish that last one, let me just finish it. Finish my 16th. There we go. Like this. Okay. So we're going to make a front post double crochet around the treble. So yarn over once, front post, so from the front to the back, around the stem of that front post double, and make a double crochet, which kind of continues the line of the double treble that we made the previous round. Chain 2. Skip 2 chain spaces, So we're going to skip this chain 2 space that we made the previous round. And we're going to make a double crochet into the next back post single crochet. So this is a back post single crochet that we're talking about. So just fold your work to the front a little bit. You can see this is the front, the back post single crochet we made the previous round. Make a double crochet into that stitch. And chain 2. Do this for all the back post single crochets that we did the previous round. So double crochet into the stitch, chain 2, skip chain space, chain 2 space, and continue doing this for all of the double of the single crochets into that are made into this corner. So chain 2. This. Chain 2 into the stitch like this, chain 2 and one more like this, there you go, chain 2. Now we've arrived at the front post, sorry, at the double treble of the previous round, make a front post double crochet around it, like this. Again, making nice line like this. double crochet to the next 17 stitches, so mirroring what we did on this side. Take care that the first one really might be a little bit hidden, so just pull your work apart a little bit. You can see this is the first half post double back post half double crochet that we have, and we're going to make a front post a double crochet in there, and then 16 more, so 17 total. This was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 17. Just make sure of the stitch count. Of course, I don't remember if I started at 1 or at 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. This is right. And of course, the placement is right as well. The last double crochet should fall into the last back post half double crochet that was made into the front post double crochet of the round before that. After those 17 double crochets, we're going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3. We're going to skip the next chain 2 space and single crochet. Let me just take a look at my work. This is a chain 2 space, and this is a single crochet. These are we are going to skip. We're going to make 3 single crochets into the next space. 1, 2, 3. Chain 2. Skip these 2 double crochets, and make 3 single crochets into the next space. Like this. Chain 2. And this we're going to continue until the end. So it really all speaks for itself. We're going to chain 2. Skip the stitches. So whether they're double crochets or single crochets, we're going to skip them. And we're going to make a chain 2 above them. And make 3 single crochets into those spaces. So I am sure you can do the rest yourself. When you're at the end, you're going to mirror what we did here, which also isn't very difficult. This is, should be quite a relaxing round. When you're done, close with a slip stitch on your first the top of your chain 2 or chain 3, and then I will see you for round 50. Round number 50. We're going to start in the first chain 2 space of the corner after the front post double. So here you have your corner. This was the front post double made into the front post treble, not the treble, double treble, sorry. And we're going to start in this chain 2 space. And we're going to make a standing double crochet into that space. Like this. Standing double crochet. We're going to make a special picot again, the sideways picot. So chain 3, get into the side of the chain 3 to the stem. That's not right. Like this. And make a single crochet. That's our first special picot. After your first special picot on the top of this double crochet, we're going to skip the next double crochet. And we're going to make 2 double crochets into the next 5 spaces with a special picot on the top. So I'm going to skip all this and make a double crochet in here with a special double crochet on top. I'm going to make 2 in each space. Like this. Like this. So 1 in the first and 2 in the second, and we're going to do the same for the third, fourth, and fifth and sixth. I'm going to do this 5 times what we just did. So just steadily do your stitches. I know these picots are sometimes a little bit tedious to make, to make them right, especially you need to go into the right chains to get that nice look and to make them look all the same as well. It's always a challenge for me then. But if you always do the same thing, whether it's exactly the way it should be done or not, if you do everything the same as the previous stitch, then you should be fine. Did this 3 times now. I'm going to do 2 more. Like this. And once more into the next space, making 2 double crochets with a special picot on top. Almost there. There you go. So we did this 5 times into 5 spaces. In the last chain 2 space of the corner, you're going to make 1 double crochet with a special picot on the top, like we did here. So in this chain 2 space, that's be right before that front post double crochet, make 1 double crochet with a special picot on the top, like this. Chain 1, now you can just count your double crochets with the picots to make sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Should be 12 of them. If you have 12 of them, you did it correctly. So we just did our chain 1. After our chain 1, we're going to skip the next front post double crochet. This one. And we're going to skip this double crochet, this first double crochet. We're going to make a back post treble into the next 16 stitches. So that means yarn twice over, skipping that front post double crochet and the first double crochet, and go from the back to the front and make a treble. Like this. I'm going to do this 16 times in total. So I'm going to make 16 back post trebles into the next 16 stitches. This is 1, 2, 3, some more yarn. I'm going to need it, all those trebles. So we did 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hates nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and this should be 16, because every stitch takes so long. I'm going to count my stitches as usual. I usually do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 treble back post trebles total. Look how pretty this looks. The nice little loops here. I just love back post stitches. After our 16 back post trebles, we're going to make a chain two. Like this. We're going to skip this next chain three space that we made the previous round. And we're going to make three double crochets into the next single crochets. No, sorry. We're going to make three double crochets to the next single crochets. So we're going to make three into the same single crochet. Let me just check the pattern. Just to be real sure. Yes, we're going to make three in there. Okay. So 1, 2, and 3. Like this. We're going to skip the next two single crochets over these and make two single crochets into the next chain two space. So, make two single crochets in there. We're going to skip the first two single crochets and make three double crochets into the next single crochet. So skip this one and this one and make it into the last single crochet. Make three double crochets into the same stitch. Like this. After this, these three double crochets, we're going to make a chain two. And we're going to repeat what we just did. We're going to skip this space and make three double crochets into the first single crochet. Two. And three. Chain two. Skip those two single crochets over here and make two single crochets into the next chain two space. So this really requires a little bit of concentration, but it's not hard. This round isn't hard. It just really needs some concentration. That's all it needs. I also don't think I need to do more. You can do the rest on your own. As you can see, what we're doing here is we're making nice little wave-like pattern. Continue this all the way around. Again, get that pattern downloaded, see what you need to do next, but we're going to mirror exactly what we did here. And when you're done, close with a slip stitch on your first stitch as usual, and I will see you for round 51. Round 51. We're going to start at the first double crochet that has a special picot in it in the corner. So this double crochet. And we're going to join with a back post single crochet. So from the back to the front, make a back post single crochet. Chain two. And make a single crochet around every double crochet that you have with a chain two in between. Just do this 12 times until you've did this with all the double crochets. Really do hope that you like doing back post stitches, because there's a lot of them in this pattern. I personally really love doing them. I think they make great detail into the work, and I also find them relaxing to do, so I really don't mind doing them. Just try to find a way that makes it relaxing for you if you have any troubles with back post stitches, because there's many people that really don't like them. Just find a way that works for you and you'll learn to love them as well. And our last single crochet and chain two. Look at the lovely little loops showing. After those 12 back post single crochets, we're going to skip this chain one space, and we're going to make a front post treble around the front post double crochet that was in round 49. Make a front post treble around that stitch like this, again elongating this nice little line. I'm going to go back to round 50. I'm going to skip this first back post treble and make a back post half double crochet around the next 15 stitches. So just skip this one, go from the back to the front for the second one. I'm going to do this 15 times 15 half double crochets. Back post half double crochets. This is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keep snagging my yarn. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, and our last one, 15. As you can see, all works out perfectly. After those 15 half back post half double crochets, we're going to work a chain one. We're going to be working into round 48. Now that's a purple round, because we did two purple rounds. So we're going to skip this chain two space. This we're going to skip. I'm going to make a treble into this chain four space over here. As you can see, it already contains the three single crochets. I'll show you how to do that. Yarn over twice. Pull your work. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Sorry for the interruption. We're going to make a treble into this chain space that already contains those three single crochets. Just go in from the bottom into the chain space, come out from the other side, work in front of the rest of your work, and make a treble like this. So basically you're making a treble crochet next or before, right before those three single crochets. Now we're going to go back to round 50 and making a back post, a back loop only single crochet into the next three stitches. So you have this group of three double crochets here. Into the first loop, back loop, we're going to make a single crochet, and also in the three loops after it. So in the next three stitches, make a back loop only single crochet like this. We're going to make two long single crochets into the space between the two double crochets of round 48, and we're going to enclose rounds 49 and 50 within your stitch. This sounds like a lot of work, but it's really very easy. You see those two double crochets here, we're going to work in between them. We're going to make a spike stitch or a long single crochet in that stitch like this. Get in between those two double crochets, pull up your yarn and pull it to the height of your work like this. It had to be a single crochet, so just do that again. Get into between those two double crochets, Get your yarn through, pull up your loop to the height of your work, and pull through. That's one. We're going to make one more. So again, in closing those previous rounds, pulling up that loop so it doesn't get too tight. As you can see, it makes a very nice effect over your work. After those two long single crochets, we're going to make a single crochet back loop only in the next four stitches. And the first one is the stitch which is hidden behind the long single crochet a little bit. As you can see, this falls over that little bit, but you need to work into that first double crochet and into back loop only, make four back loop single crochets. So three and four. Going back to round 48, making a treble into the next two free single crochets of round 48. So yarn over twice, this is yarn 48. I'm going to make a treble in both free single crochets. So just get into that single crochet and work in front of your work like this, make a treble, and do this for the second single crochet as well, like this. Look how pretty this looks. This is why I said it isn't a very hard round, but it does need concentration. So just concentrate as you do your work and you should be able to do everything because the stitches are all quite basic. After this treble into those two single crochets, we're going to do this four times. Let me just look where we're going to do that too. You see here, let's see what we need to do. Oh yes, we need to go back to round 50. I'm sorry, I had to look at the pattern. We're going to do what we did here. We're going to do this four times. So I'll show you once more and the rest you can do yourself. We're going back to round 50. Make a back loop only single crochet into the next four stitches, 2, 3, and 4. And we're going to make two long single crochets into the space between the two double crochets like we did before. So get your hook in and close all your rounds, pull up the loop to the height of your work and close to make a single crochet. And we're making one more like this. After your long single crochets, we're going to make a back loop only single crochet into the next four stitches again. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we're going to make a treble into the next three single crochets of round 48, like I showed you before as well. This is working in front of your work, not in closing any rounds. A bit more yarn for my last stitch I'm going to show you, like this, and treble. This we're going to do two more times, and then we're mirroring everything that we did here. So I'm sure you can do this on your own now. Just get the pattern again to see what you need to do, especially with the rounds that are this wordy. You really do need to take a look at the pattern every now and then. Close with a slip stitch on your first stitch, and when you're done, I will see you for round 52. Round 52. As you can see, I have the same color yarn on my hook as the previous round. The only problem is that we ended one stitch or two stitches too far. So that's why I had to cut my yarn. We're going to start in this front post treble. One advice for this round is that you really take care that you hook your chains. We're going to be hooking some chains in, on the sides loosely, because the next round we're going to work in those chain stitches like we've done before, in the eyes of those stitches. So try to hook them a little bit loosely. It doesn't matter if it's if it works a little bit wide, because we'll use them next round. So we're going to start at this front post treble and we're going to join with a front post double crochet around it, like this. There we go. Chain two. Skip this chain two space, this one. We're going to work a double crochet into the next back post single crochet, like this. Chain two, and we're going to do this for all the back post single crochets. Chain two, just work them one by one till you have 12 double crochets and chain two spaces in between. Halfway. Okay. Oh, we're almost there. Chain two. Be sure to work all those single crochets. You don't miss any. I think we have had all of them now. Yes, we did. Very good. After those 12 double crochets with the chain twos in between, we're going to chain two again, which I just did. And we're going to skip this next chain two space. And we're going to make a front post double crochet around this treble, which makes sense because we did that the other side as well, like this. That's our complete corner made. We're going to make a we're going to skip this first front post back post half double crochet, and that's not this one. I'm not going to skip this one because this is the second one. The first one is this hidden stitch over here. So really do take care. Just count your stitch to make sure, because it's really easy to miss this. I missed this the first time I did this as well, so really take care. And we're going to make a double crochet into the next 14 stitches. So skipping this stitch, in the next stitch make a double crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, and 14, I think I'm either I miscounted or I started wrong. Let me just check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yes, I did miscount. I cannot count in English apparently. And this is 14. There we go. This is right. 14 double crochets. After those 14 double crochets, we're going to make a chain 2. We're going to skip the next space. And we're going to make a single crochet into this next treble. So we're skipping this space here. make a single crochet in there in that treble, like this. Now we need to watch our tension because there's lots of chains coming up. Chain 4, not too tight. Skip the next 4 stitches, which are the stitches that we made into the back loop only. And into the long single crochets, we're going to make a double crochet. One in each. Like this. Chain 4. Again, try to hook it loosely. And into those 2 trebles, we're going to make a single crochet. One. And chain 4, and in the long single crochets, again making a double crochet. Each of them. I'll show you one last time what we're doing with the trebles. In every treble, we're making a single crochet. Now I've shown you everything there is to this round. You're going to continue what we just did until you're at the other side, mirroring what we just did, so get that pattern to make sure that you're doing the right thing still. In the end, close with a slip stitch on your first front post double, and I'll see you for round 53. Round 53. We're going to start at the first chain space of a corner shell. So we're going to start in this chain space over here. We're going to join with a standing double crochet into that chain space. Like this. And we're going to make a special picot or sideways picot in the same space. So make the picot like we have done many times before and make another double crochet into the same space like this. In the next 12 chain spaces, we're going to make double crochet, special picot, double crochet, and we're going to skip all of these double crochets. Because this takes quite a while, I will do my stitches, and when I'm at the other side, I'm going to meet you again to show you the rest of it. Continuing for round 53, as you can see, I just made my 13 groups of 2 double crochets with a chain with a special picot in between. Just finished my last one. We're going to skip this front post double crochet, make a back post half double crochet into the next 14 double crochets. So I'm going to make half double crochets into these 14 double crochets. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, oh, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Made 14 back post half double crochets like this. Now we're going to make lots of more half double crochets, but in the back loop only of the next 64 stitches. And most of them are going to be made into the chain stitches, so I'll show you how to do that. First of all, the first two will be in the chain two. So just look for those two back loops. This is the first back loop. Get through that loop of the chains and make a half double crochet. No, I've already went one too far. I'll just go back one stitch. This is the first loop I want. There we go. And the next loop is the one right next to it. There we go. Like this. Of course, we'll make a half double back loop, half double crochet into the single crochet. And now we're going to make four back loop double half double crochets into this chain space. And just get them loop by loop. So one, two, three, and four. I know it's a little bit fiddly, but the pattern really wants you to work into the back loops and not into the chain space itself. And as you do more of them, you'll see that you see the loops quite easily. And of course, two half double crochets into the back loops of these double crochets. Get that loop, make a half double crochet in both back loops. Like this. Show you a little bit more. Make a back loop, half double crochet into the next four chain stitches. One, two, three, and four. Yes, it is a little bit fiddly, but believe me, you can do it, especially if you did work the previous round loosely, like we were saying. And then into the next two single crochets, we're going to also make two half double back loop, half double crochets into those loops. Just get into the loop. There we go. Yes, there we are. This we're going to do for the whole side. We're just going to make 64 half double crochet in the back loop only. So what I want you to do is after you finish each round, or after you finished I would just say after you finish each round, just count your half double crochets. If they're not 64, do smuggle one or two to get to 64, because you really need to have 64 stitches. But if you did everything correctly so far, you should end up with 64. Do what we did in this video all the way around, so mirror it on the other side. And then I'll see you for round 54. Round 54, the last round of part 5 of this crochet along. We're going to start with a different color. And we're going to start at the first double crochet of any corner shell. So I'm going to start over here. Work's becoming a little bit bigger, so I have to maneuver it around a little bit. And we're going to start with a back post single crochet around that first double crochet. So from the back to the front, make a back post single crochet like this. Chain one. Back post single crochet around the next double crochet as well. So skipping this picot. Like this. Back post single crochet around the next double crochet. Chain one. And back post single crochet around the next double crochet. Like this. So, again, to just summarize, we're making a back post single crochet, chain one, back post single crochet, back post single crochet, chain one, back post single crochet. That's what we did so far, just to realize what you're doing. So it makes it a lot easier when you know the order or the logic around behind your stitches. After those back post single crochets, we're going to make a back post half double crochet around the next double crochet. So, like this. Make a back post half double crochet, chain one, back post half double crochet around the next double crochet. Like this. We're going to do this twice. So again, back post half double crochet, chain one, back post half double crochet. Of course, you might be able to guess what your next step is going to be. It's going to be a back post double crochet around the next double crochet, chain one, and a back post half a double crochet around the next double crochet as well. And we're going to repeat this again with this second pair. So back post double crochet, chain one, back post double crochet. Like this. This way we're creating a little bit of a corner, like this. After this last back post double crochet, we're going to make a back post treble around the next double crochet. So this next double crochet, we're going to make a treble, back post treble around it, like this. And after this treble, we're going to make a chain three and another treble around the next double crochet. Like this. So this is the real new corner made. Instead of this huge corner all counting as a corner, this is our new corner. We're going to mirror what we just did as I get a little bit more yarn. We're going to make a back post double crochet around the next double crochet, chain one, back post double crochet, and we're going to repeat this. After our two sets of double back post double crochet, chain one, back post double crochets, we're going to make two sets of back post half double crochets with a chain one in between. That's one. And that makes two. And into our next last groups of double crochets, we're going to make a back post single crochet with a chain one in between. No chain one. Really do take care that the chain one is only done to gap or bridge the gap of the special picot. So in between the grooves, you're not making a chain one because that would make your work way too wide. So take care. Again, here you'd make a chain one, but here you wouldn't. And that counts for all of the stitches. Now that we've finished the corner, I'm going to move on to the next part. And we're going to make a half double crochet two together in the next two stitches with a chain one in between. Okay, this sounds like a lot, but it's really, really easy. We're not going to skip this first stitch, so take care. You really need to really take care so you don't miss this first stitch. And get into that stitch. Almost there. Yes. And to make a half double crochet two together, you insert the hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. Now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over, insert the hook into your next stitch, pull up a loop, five loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all five loops. That's how you make a half double crochet two together. Chain one and half double crochet two together into the next stitch. We're not skipping any stitches, just working immediately into the next stitch, like this. There we go. Chain one, and to the next stitch, and the next one after that. This is what we're doing. We're making half double crochets two together. I'll show you one detailed one last time. So chain one. We're working in this stitch and this stitch for our half double crochet two together. Get into this stitch, three loops on your hook. Get into the next stitch, five loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through. Chain one. So this is the look that you're going for. You're going to do this 45 times. In the end, you're going to make another half double crochet two together without a chain one in the end, because you're going to go on with the back post single crochets immediately. You should be able to do this round now without more of my help. I just mirror what you have been doing. Thank you all for watching this Jacaranda part 5. I really enjoyed making these videos for you. I hope you continue with us for part 6, and have a great crochet day.